Hi, welcome to Programming with Mesh. In this session, we will configure the VS Code for React Native and we'll learn the basics of working with it. In the previous sessions, we created the React Native project and run it in VS Code environment. Now we will take a closer look at how to work with this IDE and we set it up to make coding easier for us. During this tutorial, we will work with this editor. For serious coding, you'll often benefit from tools with more code understanding than just blocks of text. Visual Studio Code includes built-in support for IntelliSense code completion, rich semantic code understanding and navigation, and code refactoring. VS Code helps you be instantly productive with syntax highlighting, bracket matching, auto indentation, box selection, snippets, and more. So we go to the official page of Visual Studio Code. And from there, we choose the latest version that fits our operating system. After installing and opening the VS Code, from this section, select the project folder to open in the IDE environment. On the left, you will see the contents of the project folder. Open the app.js file to check a few things about it. To zoom in, use the Ctrl and equals buttons, and to zoom out, use the Ctrl and dash buttons. We also use the Ctrl and 0 keys to reset the zoom. I zoom in a little to make the page look better. You can use Ctrl and K and T keys to change the theme in the VS Code. Or select the color theme option from the File menu and Preferences. I have used the Dark Plus theme here. You can choose a theme from the default themes according to your taste. So back to the Dark Plus theme. In the extensions section, we can use many useful plugins to make coding easier for us. Installing these plugins is completely optional, and here are some commonly used plugins based on my experiences. The first plugin is the Material Icon theme. This plugin takes your coding environment out of monotony and changes the icon of the files beautifully. Also, after a while, you can recognize the file type from the icons. From here, we install the plugin. The theme of the icons is on the Setty by default, which we changed to Material Icon theme. As you can see, the file icons has changed. Also, if you want to change this theme in the future, you can do it from the Preferences section, File Icon theme. If you don't want to use the default color theme, you can use new themes using extensions. To do this, select the last option from the Color Theme menu to show a list of available themes in the extension section. For example, this theme makes the VS Code look like Atom text editor. Or you can choose any of the themes to your liking and after installation, activate them from the Color Theme menu. The next plugin is React Native Snippet, which provides you JavaScript and React or Redux snippets in ES7 with Babel plugin features for VS Code. By installing this plugin, you can write a repetitive piece of code in React Native by typing just a few letters. For example, by typing the letters IMP, you can enter this repetitive phrase that is used to import libraries. Only here, we enter the name of the module and the main name of the library. Or by entering this prefix, we will import this from React. These prefixes are too many and don't need to be memorized. You can use them only when you enter the first letters of a method. This plugin also has shortcuts for repetitive components. For example, to enter this component, just enter these four letters. The next plugin is React Native Tools, which is actually a tool to make running and debugging projects easier. For example, in the comment palette, it shows the commands to execute the React Native app. It also provides a tool for debugging in VS Code. The next plugin is Color Highlight. This extension displays the color code in the editor in the same color, which helps a lot in designing the page. For example, if we use hex code instead of the default black color, it will show the color code in the same color. The next plugin is Bracket Pair Colorizer. This extension allows matching brackets to be identified with colors, and it helps a lot in understanding curling codes, where the method started and where it ended. For example, in this piece of code, we can quickly find out where the method started and where it ended after several lines. The next plugin is NPM IntelliSense that autocompletes NPM modules in import statements. If you plan to work as a team in the future, the Git Lens plugin will help you a lot to manage the Git in VS Code without knowing the Git commands. If our codes are cluttered, their readability will decrease. We can use the default VS Code parameter to format the code. For example, I enter a few tabs before this code and then sort it with the Alt-Shift-F keys, so that you don't have to worry about saving what you have written while coding. It's better to enable the autosave option. On the main page that we work with, we can do personalization from the view menu. For example, by activating the Show Minimap option, a small map is displayed on the right that can be easily scrolled in large codes. You can close the left panel by clicking on the icon that is active to have more space for coding. To open a new terminal, select New Terminal from the Terminal menu. Clicking on the cross, Terminal only hides, and by clicking on the trash icon, you can kill the terminal. If you hide the terminal, you can show the terminal again from the View menu with the Terminal option or with its shortcuts. And if we open a new terminal again, we can switch between them from this part. From this section, you can search or replace. To do this, you can enter the desired text in the search field to search for results in the project content. You can also do this with a shortcut. Select the desired text and by pressing Ctrl-Shift-F, view the search results. You can view the contents of a file by clicking once, but if you click on another file, its contents will replace the previous file. In order for the content of the file to remain on the page, you must open it by double-clicking. Or you can double-click on the tab of the file. If you want to have more space for coding, you can choose from Appearance, Full Screen or Zen Mode. You can use the F11 button to switch between Full Screen Mode and Normal Mode. Zen Mode can also multiply your focus on coding. You can also use the F11 button to exit this mode. So there we go, we configured the VS Code for React Native and we learned the basics of working with it. We are now ready to start coding in this environment. So in the next video, we will review the React Native structure and learn about the important components for building a project. Now, if you enjoyed the video, please don't forget to share, subscribe, and like, and I'll see you in the next session.